this video, we're going to be proving the derivative of sine of x is equal to the cosine of x function. As a review, we know that the definition for a derivative is defined through, for any function, the limit as our change in x represented by h goes to 0 of the f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. And with this limit definition for a derivative, we can apply it into our sine derivative. So sine of x's derivative, if we apply into this derivative definition, will be equal to the limit as our change in x represented by h goes to 0 of the sine of x plus h minus sine of x divided by h. Because our f of x in this case is the sine of x, so we simply substitute sine of x into f of x plus h and f of x to obtain this limit as so. This limit can then be further simplified into the limit as h approaches to 0 of sine of x times the cosine of h plus the cosine of x times the sine of h minus sine of x divided by h. And this comes from our trigonometric property, which states that the sine of two numbers added together will be equal to the sine of x times the cosine of y plus the cosine of x times the sine of y times the sine of y. So we applied it into our limit to get this limit right here. When we expanded sine of x plus h, this limit will be further simplified into the limit as h approaches to 0. We can factor out a sine of x from sine of x times cosine of h minus sine of x. They both contain the sine term, sine of x term, so this will then be equal to the sine of x factored out times cosine of h minus 1 plus the cosine of x times the sine of h divided by h. So, and after we do this, we can break up this limit to be equal to the limit as h approaches to 0 of sine of x times the cosine of h minus 1 divided by h plus the limit as h goes to 0 of cosine of x times the sine of h divided by h. And the reason why we can do this is because of our limit property, which states that the limit as x approaches to some number of the sum of two functions represented by f of x and g of x is equal to the limit as x approaches to n of our first function added to the limit as x approaches to that number of our second function g of x. Therefore, we can break the limit as so right here. Right here. And now that we have broken up this limit, we can evaluate each limit individually. So let us first evaluate this limit right here, which I've circled in red. So that limit as h goes to 0 of the sine of x times the cosine of h minus 1 divided by h will be equal to the product of two limits, which is the limit as h approaches to 0 of sine of x times the limit as h goes to 0 of cosine of h minus 1 divided by h. And the reason why we can do this is because of another limit property, which states that the product of two functions of a limit is equal to the limit as x approaches to a certain number of our first function times the limit of our second function when x goes to n, which is g of x. Therefore, we can break this limit right here into the product of these two limits. So these two limits can then be separately and individually evaluated. Because this limit has to do with the h variable as h goes to 0, or our change in x, this x right here has nothing to do with our h variable. So we can view sine of x as a constant. In the function of a constant times another function will simply be equal to when we take that function, or the constant rather, out of the limit. So the limit property, which is the limit when x approaches to n of a constant represented by c times f of x, a function, will be equal to if we take the constant out of the limit times the limit as x approaches to n of f of x. So we can apply it into this limit right here, because sine of x has nothing to do with h variable. So this will be equal to the sine of x times the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 minus this limit right here. The limit of cosine of h minus 1 divided by h is h goes to 0. And we know once again from another limit property that the limit as x approaches to 0 of the cosine of x minus 1 divided by x is equal to 0. Therefore, we can apply this limit property into this limit to get this is equal to times 0. It's supposed to be a times sign, not a subtract sign. So sine of x times limit as h goes to 0, right here, this limit, well, the limit of a function is equal to, the limit of a constant is equal to that constant. So this turns out to be 1. 1 times sine of x turns out to be sine of x. And we all know that sine of x times 0 is equal to 0. So we evaluated our first limit right here. So this limit that I've just circled in red previously, this all cancels out to be 0. And now we can evaluate our second half of the limit, which is the limit as h goes to 0 of the cosine of x times sine of h divided by h. So if I scroll down, as so, and I'll draw it here, which is the limit as h goes to 0 of the cosine of x times the sine of h divided by h. We're trying to evaluate this limit. So we know that this limit can be broken up into product of two limits when the limit h goes to 0 of cosine of x times the limit as h goes to 0 of sine of h divided by h from our previous limit property of the product of two functions. So we can evaluate this limit first, this first limit right here. And once again, with the same logic we did for the previous sine of x when h goes to 0, this h goes to 0 right here has nothing to do with the x variable, because the h variable is going to 0, not the x variable. So we can treat cosine of x as a constant. So this will be equal to, remember our previous limit property, which states that we can take the constant out of the limit, will be equal to the constant of cosine of x times limit as h goes to 0 of 1 times this limit right here. And we know from another limit property, which states that the limit as x goes to 0 of sine of x divided by x is equal to 1. You can apply this limit property into this limit right here. Therefore, this will be cosine of x times the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 times 1, which will be equal to, when we evaluate this limit, the limit of a constant is equal to a constant, so this turns out to be 1 times the cosine of x turns out to be cosine of x. So this becomes cosine of x. And what we have ended up with is this sine derivative, this sine x's derivative is equal to 0 plus the cosine of x, which is equal to the cosine of x. So we have proved that the derivative of sine of x is equal to the cosine of x.